All right, hello. Day 46, 47, can't really remember at this point. I am back to the butcher block. I sanded it the other day, and today I am coming back to do sort of the mineral spirits to make sure that we get off all of the remaining dust that could or would be on here so that we have a really nice base to basically put the tongue oil stain on there treatment for the butcher block. Before I do that, I wanted to show Doug had the molding on here so we have a nice finished look all the way around. I have not filled it or painted or anything, but that's the next step. So before I get started today, necessary, you know, he's the worker, he's not the cleaner. So I do need to come through and pick up all the shavings and stuff down here with the shop vac and get that done so that I have a clean space to work from. So gonna do that, and then when we pop back here, we will get working on cleaning and creating a nice smooth surface for our butcher block prep. Okay, so I have prepped the area and now I'm gonna get ready to use the mineral spirits, the paint thinner here on the counter, which will explain this sexy shirt in just a minute. But the reason I wanted to kind of go back to maybe what we had talked about in the previous video when we were doing the sanding and then we were gonna put the conditioner. After a little bit more research, and truth be told, a little bit of nervousness on my part, I've dealt with butcher block before, but with a cutting board. I've never personally had butcher block counters in my life. I've seen them, but the way you treat a cutting board and use it is much different than when you're dealing with the countertop. And the way that people are installing these countertops are a little bit different than maybe from a long, long time ago when people were cutting right on their counters. A lot of folks right now are putting them in for the looks rather than to actually use them as a cutting surface. Our intention here, my intention is to have it as a just a beautiful separate island, not necessarily as a cutting surface, because just the maintenance that comes along with it. We'll see if this is a big mistake or not. But that being said, the instructions that are out there are very, very conflicting for how you treat, condition, prep, stain, butcher block counters. And I kept reading different ones, I'm watching different YouTube videos, I'm seeing different product sites, and it just led me down this path of like, oh my gosh, can we really do this? And so after a couple more delays, and truth be told, I have been putting off the butcher block countertop. It made sense in the beginning because I didn't want it damaged. But now we're coming to the end of the line, and it's like, Lindsay, let's go, let's get this done. So now that there are no more excuses, Doug has finished the trim, I need to get my butt in gear here and get this done. So I had sanded it with the 150 grit and brushed it all off, and then it was, hey, it's time to put on the conditioner. Started looking a little bit more because I was trying to find the stain. And you, even though this is not meant to be a prep surface, it's still in a kitchen. So there's certain products that you have to use when you're talking about a kitchen counter because they need to be food grade and they need to be safe just in case somebody were to use it for food prep. So I'm looking, and finally I went to like, hey, I think there's a product card that came with the countertop. And so, I wish I had it here. So I found it, I read it, and what do you know? It says, use this specific product called Waterlox, which I had seen all over the place. And so, looked them up, also called a couple paint stores, and because this is a pretty specific product, it's not just carried any old place. There's a lot of imitators, there's a lot of other products similar to this, but not, this company's product per se. So after some chats with them, and they were amazing on the phone, I will come back to that later, but took me down a completely different path of what I am gonna do to prep this countertop so that it looks absolutely beautiful and that it's easier to maintain. So step that I'm deviating here, instead of adding the conditioner and sanding again, Nice thing is, I don't need to sand anymore, which I'm very happy about. But now I am going to use the paint thinner slash mineral spirits, however you want to use that term, to basically wipe this baby all down, get all of the remaining dust, and then it's gonna sit. All this is gonna evaporate, right? All the fumes go bye-bye. And then it is ready to go for me to add their tongue oil stain tomorrow. So this is what I'm gonna be doing today. Got the sexy shirt on to protect what I have on underneath, just in case, you know, this gets on anything. And I'm gonna get to work on this. So I'm gonna cut the video here, and then I'll reposition the camera, and you may see me get into work here. So thank you for humoring me, and here we go. Do-it-yourself ButcherBot countertop. Okay, so I'm ready to go. Got my fun shirt on, got my paint thinner, I have my gloves to protect my hands, and you know, the girls are always here in spirit. I have some of Adriana and Elena's old pants that no longer fit. I'm gonna use this because these are nice, clean, and lint-free, and I'm gonna rub everything on here. I am pressed for time because I have some stock cooking for soup at home. So I only got about 11 minutes. We'll see if I can get this done that quickly. Not that I want to rush this, but what the video did tell me is basically do not belabor the point. There's no reason to beat a dead horse here. Get it done and get the heck out. I also don't want to die from fumes, so